Let me take you back to ancient Greece, where the story of Medusa, the Gorgon, captivated the imagination of many and inspired artists, writers, and scholars for centuries. As we journey back in time to ancient Greece, we embark on an intriguing exploration of one of the most captivating tales of Greek mythology, the legend of Medusa. With her striking appearance and enthralling backstory, Medusa has mesmerized audiences for centuries and continues to do so even in modern times. From art to literature to popular culture, Medusa's image has been interpreted in various ways, making her an enduring symbol of fearlessness, danger, and female power. As we delve into the different chapters of her story, we uncover the nuances and complexities of this myth and the ways in which it continues to captivate and inspire us today. The myth of Medusa has remained a timeless and fascinating tale, passed down through generations of cultures, each interpreting it in their way. Whether it is the story of a beautiful young woman turned into a monstrous gorgon or the tale of a victim of sexual assault, Medusa's story has captured the imagination of many. Chapter 1, The Controversial Tale of Medusa and Poseidon. The mythological tale of Medusa is a controversial story that revolves around the young woman's encounter with Poseidon, the god of the sea. According to the ancient Greek myths, Medusa was a beautiful young woman who served as a priestess of Athena, the goddess of wisdom. It is said that Poseidon became infatuated with Medusa and, in an attempt to seduce her, he visited her in Athena's temple. However, Medusa refused his advances and attempted to flee. It was then that Poseidon abused her in the temple, desecrating the holy space. The story of Medusa and Poseidon's encounter is a controversial one, with interpretations varying on whether the act was consensual or not. Some scholars argue that Medusa's attempt to flee and the fact that she was in Athena's temple implies that the act was non-consensual. Others suggest that the act may have been consensual, as ancient Greek myths often depict gods and mortals engaging in romantic relationships. Regardless of the interpretation, the story of Medusa and Poseidon's encounter is a significant moment in the mythological tale, as it marks the beginning of Medusa's transformation from a beautiful young woman to a monster with snakes for hair and a gaze that could turn people to stone. This chapter delves into the controversial story of Medusa and Poseidon, which has sparked debates among scholars and artists over the years. According to some interpretations, the intercourse between Medusa and Poseidon was consensual, and the transformation of Medusa into a gorgon was a punishment for breaking her vow of celibacy as a priestess of Athena. However, other versions of the myth, including the one told by the Roman poet Ovid, suggest that Poseidon abused Medusa against her will, and her transformation was a result of her trauma and shame. Regardless of the interpretation, Medusa's story represents the vulnerability of women in the face of male power and the silencing of their voices. The chapter highlights how the myth of Medusa continues to be relevant in modern times, as it prompts us to reflect on issues of gender, consent, and power dynamics in society. The controversy surrounding Medusa and Poseidon's story serves as a reminder that there are often multiple perspectives to any story and that we should approach them with empathy and an open mind. Chapter 2, Athena's Hatred and Punishment. In Greek mythology, Athena was the goddess of wisdom, war, and crafts. She was also one of the most powerful deities in the Greek pantheon. However, despite her reputation as a wise and just goddess, Athena harbored a deep hatred for Medusa, the Gorgon. This chapter delves into the reasons behind Athena's animosity towards Medusa. According to the myth, Medusa was once a beautiful maiden who caught the eye of Poseidon, the god of the sea. However, Athena caught them together in her temple, and in her rage, turned Medusa into a Gorgon, a creature with snakes for hair and the ability to petrify anyone who looked at her directly. It was believed that Athena's jealousy over Medusa's beauty and her perceived violation of her temple led her to punish Medusa in such a manner. Athena's hatred for Medusa did not end with her transformation. Instead, she continued to harbor animosity towards Medusa, seeing her as a threat to the patriarchal power structure of ancient Greece. As a powerful goddess and a symbol of femininity, Medusa represented a challenge to Athena's dominance, and Athena sought to eliminate this threat by sending Perseus to slay her. In the myth, Athena provides Perseus with several gifts to aid him in his quest to slay Medusa. These gifts include a mirrored shield, which allows him to see Medusa's reflection without being turned to stone, and a sword, with which he is able to decapitate her. Athena's assistance in Perseus's quest reflects her determination to eliminate any challenge to her authority, even if it means destroying another powerful female figure. The conflict between Athena and Medusa represents a larger societal struggle between femininity and patriarchal power. Athena's hatred for Medusa highlights how even powerful female figures were not immune to the misogyny and patriarchal structures of ancient Greece. Medusa's transformation into a Gorgon and her subsequent death at the hands of Perseus symbolize the subjugation of femininity and the triumph of masculine power over female strength and independence. The chapter goes on to explore the complexity of Athena's character and how her actions towards Medusa are not entirely clear-cut. Some scholars believe that Athena may have been trying to protect Medusa from unwanted advances by men, which would have resulted in her being abused and dishonored. By turning her into a Gorgon, Athena may have been attempting to give her the power to protect herself. However, others argue that Athena's actions were motivated by jealousy and spite. Medusa was said to be a beautiful priestess in Athena's temple, and some versions of the myth suggest that Medusa caught the eye of Poseidon, Athena's rival. Enraged by this, Athena punished Medusa by turning her into a monster. Regardless of Athena's true intentions, her hatred towards Medusa played a crucial role in the myth's outcome. Without Athena's involvement, Perseus would not have been sent on his quest to slay Medusa, and her fate may have been different. The chapter concludes by highlighting the ongoing debate over Athena's character and her role in the myth of Medusa. Chapter 3, The Three Gorgons. Although Medusa is the most well-known Gorgon, she was not the only one. In fact, she had two immortal sisters named Theno and Euryale. In this chapter, we will learn more about these three sisters and the little that is known about them. According to Greek mythology, the Gorgons were the daughters of Phorcy and Keto, who were sea deities. The sisters were known to be winged and have snakes for hair, as well as the ability to turn people to stone with their gaze. While Medusa is the most famous of the sisters, not much is known about Theno and Euryale. However, it is believed that they shared similar characteristics to Medusa, including their appearance. Ancient artists often depicted the three sisters together, and they were known to be fearsome creatures. Some myths suggest that the Gorgons were created to serve as guardians of the underworld. However, others suggest that they were simply dangerous creatures that should be avoided at all costs. Whatever their purpose may have been, the Gorgons remain an intriguing part of Greek mythology. It is also worth noting that the Gorgons are not the only creatures in Greek mythology to have snakes for hair. The story of the Gorgons may have been inspired by other myths or legends, and it is possible that the concept of the snake-haired creature existed in other cultures as well. Despite the lack of information about Theno and Euryale, the three Gorgon sisters continue to be an intriguing part of Greek mythology. Their appearance, abilities, and purpose have inspired countless artists, writers, and filmmakers throughout the centuries, making them an enduring symbol of both danger and femininity. Chapter 4, Perseus and Medusa. In Greek mythology, Perseus is known as the legendary hero who slayed the Gorgon Medusa, and in this chapter, we delve into the details of their epic encounter. Armed with gifts from the gods, including a helmet, a mirrored shield, winged sandals, and a sword, Perseus embarked on his mission to kill the feared Medusa. The battle between Perseus and Medusa was a fierce one, as Medusa's petrifying gaze threatened to turn Perseus to stone with a single glance. But with the help of Athena's mirrored shield, Perseus was able to look at Medusa's reflection instead of directly at her, allowing him to strike the fatal blow with his sword. Perseus used helmet to become invisible, and used the winged sandals to fly away from Medusa who were chasing after him. This chapter also explores the various versions of the story, including some where Perseus is aided by Hermes and Athena, and others where he must use cunning and trickery to defeat Medusa. The tale has captured the imaginations of countless artists, writers, and filmmakers over the centuries, inspiring many adaptations and interpretations of the epic story. The battle between Perseus and Medusa is not just a physical one, but also a symbolic one, representing the victory of reason over emotion and the triumph of masculinity over femininity. This chapter delves into the deeper meanings behind the myth and how it has influenced art, literature, and popular culture throughout history. After slaying Medusa, Perseus quickly fled the scene, knowing that Medusa's sisters, the Gorgons, would seek revenge. As he flew away on his winged sandals, drops of Medusa's blood fell to the ground, giving rise to Pegasus, the winged horse in Chrysaor. Perseus returned to the kingdom of Seriphos, where he had been raised as a child, and presented the head of Medusa to King Polydex as a gift. The king had been seeking a way to get rid of Perseus and had ordered him to bring back the head of the Gorgon, thinking it was an impossible task. However, the return of Perseus with the head of Medusa was not the end of his adventures. Perseus used Medusa's head as a weapon against his enemies, turning them to stone with just one glance. He also used it to rescue Andromeda, a princess who was to be sacrificed to a sea monster. Medusa's head remained a powerful talisman in Greek mythology, representing the power to turn one's enemies to stone. It was also said to possess healing powers, as seen in the story of the birth of Asclepius, the Greek god of healing, who was born from the blood that dripped from the severed neck of Medusa. The tale of Perseus and Medusa has inspired many artists throughout history, from ancient Greek pottery to modern-day cinema. The image of Medusa's head, with its snakes for hair and petrifying gaze, has become an iconic symbol of danger and power. In popular culture, Medusa's image has been used in a variety of ways, from video games to fashion. The idea of dangerous or fearless femininity, represented by Medusa, challenges patriarchal power and inspires new interpretations of the myth. Overall, the story of Perseus and Medusa is a classic tale of heroism, with its themes of bravery, cunning, and triumph over evil. Medusa's legacy, both as a warning against vanity and as a symbol of power, continues to fascinate and inspire people to this day. Chapter 5, Medusa's Legacy, a Symbol of Fearless Femininity. Medusa's legacy has endured for centuries and continues to captivate people in modern times. Her image has been reimagined and interpreted in various forms of media, including movies, video games, fashion, and art. Medusa's story has been used as a source of inspiration for women who challenge the patriarchal system and embrace their inner strength. Medusa is a symbol of feminine power that is often feared and misunderstood. Her image has been distorted in popular culture, where she is portrayed as a monstrous creature that must be destroyed. However, some interpretations see her as a victim of male violence, transformed into a hideous creature against her will. In recent years, there has been a resurgence of interest in Medusa's image as a symbol of fearless femininity. Her snake hair and piercing gaze are seen as symbols of empowerment and defiance, challenging the norms of traditional femininity. Medusa has been portrayed as a hero in video games, where she uses her powers to fight against oppressive forces. In fashion, Medusa's image has been reimagined in various ways, including on clothing, jewelry, and accessories. Her image has been used to represent strength, independence, and rebellion. The Medusa head has become a popular motif in luxury fashion, representing the edginess and danger of the brand. In art, Medusa's image has been interpreted in various forms, including paintings, sculptures, and installations. Her image has been used to represent the duality of beauty and danger, challenging the traditional portrayal of women as passive objects of desire. Medusa's story has also been used to explore themes of transformation, trauma, and empowerment. In conclusion, Medusa's legacy continues to inspire and fascinate people in modern times. Her image challenges traditional gender roles and represents the power and resilience of women who have been oppressed and silenced. Medusa's story is a reminder that women can be both beautiful and powerful, and that they should not be afraid to embrace their inner strength and defy the norms of patriarchal society. Chapter 6, The Lessons We Can Learn from Medusa's Story. The story of Medusa is not just a myth, but a powerful metaphor for understanding ourselves and the world around us. Here are some important lessons we can learn from her story. Beware of vanity, Medusa's beauty was her undoing. Her obsession with her looks led her to make a deal with Athena, which ultimately led to her transformation into a monster. We should be careful not to become so obsessed with our appearance or status that we lose sight of what's truly important. The danger of jealousy. Medusa was punished by Athena because of Poseidon's infatuation with her. Athena's jealousy and anger towards Medusa were misplaced, but the consequences were dire. We should be aware of the harm that jealousy and envy can cause and try to avoid acting on them. The consequences of violence. Medusa's gaze turned people to stone, which was a form of violence. Violence, even in self-defense, can have serious consequences. We should strive to find peaceful solutions to conflicts whenever possible. The dangers of objectification. Medusa was turned into a monster and treated as an object because of her beauty. This highlights the danger of objectification and how it can lead to dehumanization. We should strive to treat others as individuals with their own unique personalities and not just as objects to be admired or used. The complexity of human nature. Medusa's story is not a simple one of good versus evil. It is a complex tale of love, jealousy, revenge, and redemption. This highlights the complexity of human nature and the need for empathy and understanding in our interactions with others. We should strive to understand the complexity of human nature and not reduce people to simplistic labels or categories.